college is about living and learning. From academics to friends, Greek life to campus ministries, experiencing life to the fullest. Chronicling the times of Northwestern State University, this is Demon Life.
Good afternoon, I'm Katherine Harper with NSU Demon Life. Today we have our special guest, Dr. Bill Housel, Coordinator of Social Sciences, and Tracy LeBaum Norris, Assistant Director of Counseling and Career Service at NSU. Here today they're going to discuss about what they had to offer. I'm right now in Dr. Housel's class, and he has been going over about discussing whether or not to go to graduate school. And we also had Tracy LeBaum Norris join us in the class discussing the job market. Thank you, and thank you so much for taking your time out and joining us today.
Pleasure.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Now, can you perhaps, what do you think graduate school, what does graduate school offer that can benefit a student?
Well, the first thing is that this is a good question because this is where you have to start out is what do you need it for? Mm-hmm. If you don't need grad school to do whatever it is that your plan for life is, don't do it. It's a big commitment. It's a lot of work. If you want to do it, it involves going very much deeper into your subject matter, whatever subject that may be, history, political science, economics, whatever it is that you're doing. And getting into much deeper knowledge of it and much broader knowledge of it. And if you go on for a PhD, it involves the ability to create new knowledge in your subject area.
Okay, great. And do you have anyone coming into you talking about whether or not they want to go into graduate school just because they want to make more money, or, you know, do they just want to learn more?
I have a lot of students that will come in and actually talk about their interest in graduate school, mm-hmm. not necessarily about the money. It's more of how do I go about actually getting started? How do I apply? What's out there for me? What's probably going to be the best bet, best suit for mm-hmm. me pertaining to whatever their career path they think that they want to actually take, and just trying to link them in that sense.
And what mistakes do you think that graduating seniors, if they are just going right into the job market, what mistakes do you think they make looking for a job?
I think the most common that graduating seniors will make is underestimating the market. Mm-hmm. That's one of the biggest ones, and just underestimating how much preparation it takes to actually get ready for the world of work.
And can you elaborate more on understanding the market? What do you mean by underestimating it?
Well, a lot of times students, seniors, mm-hmm. seniors, they're concentrating, they're at the tail end of undergrad, they're so excited, they're ready to get out of school, they're thinking about those last few little check-off things that they need to do, finishing up their curriculum, all of those types of things, and a lot of times they don't really put the time and the energy in as far as trying to prepare for the world of work. And when I say that, I mean getting ready as far as making sure that you're a strong candidate for hire. A lot of times we know our concentrated area pretty well, but what happens is that we don't market ourselves as well. So that's where our services will come in with different programs that can actually help them with wherever they are and help address those needs in order for them to apply for whatever it is that they're interested in, if it's either graduate school or if it's just going on to a professional position.
Do you think that it's becoming now more days, it's no longer just having a college degree, but more what you studied in college?
Okay, what do you mean?
I mean, like, you know, they say if you just have a college degree, you can get a job anywhere. But nowadays, you might need a college degree in a certain area.
Well, I mean, it just depends on what it is that they're applying for. It just depends. Some areas it may be, you know, as long as you have a degree, an undergrad degree, mm-hmm. then we can build on that. Okay. That's what some companies or some organizations may say. And because actually if you get the degree in whatever, you know, if it's just a general major or whatever your major may have been, then they feel that you've stuck to a plan and then you can build on it. So those are things that are fine. But in some areas, people are looking, or employers, they're looking for specific type of skills for you to actually have.
Now, Dr. Housel, what do you think some of the are the wrong reasons to go into graduate school and ignore the job market?
Going to grad school because you don't want to get a job is one of the top ones. Yeah. A lot of times seniors will get to that last year and all of a sudden it's decision time again. Mm-hmm. And they had a hard time deciding whether to go to school or not. Now they're having a hard time, do I go and get a job or do I stay in school? It's kind of comfortable in school, you know. And they may decide to go on for that reason.
Yeah. Do you guys ever see a professional student that student that just won't leave, and you guys have to go, okay, we're kicking you out, but you know you can't. But yeah. I'm sure you guys have seen that, and you just try to tell them, we know you can make it. That's good.
Sometimes students will actually, like now, they'll say, oh, the job market is not really, really, you know, good. So what they'll turn around and do is say, I'll stay in school or I'll continue my education, hoping that they can ride out whatever's going on now, increase their, you know, their academics. And
what are the negative outcomes that can have from doing that?
Sometimes it may not necessarily be needed. And that's kind of what he was talking about, what Dr. Housel was talking about earlier. Sometimes students will actually just go to graduate school out of fear. I don't know what's out there. I'm not sure. Let me just go and do this. I know school, so I'll do school. But that's not always the best route to go. You know, so sometimes they kind of fear that in a sense. But they understand what school is and how that's mapped out. So they'll do that.
And I think whether you go to grad school or not, I think getting some good research skills, because when you're going to the job market, a lot of people just make the mistake of they just keep sending resumes. You know, they just paper the universe with resumes. and they're not looking, you know, they're applying for jobs they don't even want, just for the sake of applying.
Now, let's talk about something that you're going to need regardless if you're going to job market or graduate school. Okay. Kat's got my tongue today. Recommendations are, you know, letters of recommendation and everything. What does a student have to do to get you guys to write a letter of recommendation, especially you, Dr. Housel, since you?
Well, first off, the advice I give is don't wait until the last minute, because that's just really irritating. If you ask a professor for a letter of recommendation, give them at least a couple of weeks. Don't hesitate to remind them after a few days. Don't forget, because we do forget it. You know, we get busy and things happen like that. Also, make sure that the person you're asking for a recommendation is going to be willing to give you a good one. You know, if you took one class from the guy, you got a C and you barely went to class, not going to be a very good, you know, and it's going to make him uncomfortable. You know, you should ask people who are going to be comfortable giving you a good recommendation based on your academics.
Okay. Yeah. So, you know, graduate schools can tell the difference when it's an actual letter of recommendation or it's just a general, he came to class, he took this. And I guess the same could be true about job references whenever.
Absolutely. It just depends. Different employers, schools, they may ask for some type of recommendation about that potential candidate. But what will happen is that I would say that if anyone is asking anyone to have a letter of recommendation written, they need to be true to themselves about. So if I'm going to ask Dr. Housel to write one, I need to be honest with myself. Did I go to class? Did I do what I was supposed to do? You know, really be honest. If it comes down to something about just a reference for work, did I show up on time at my previous? And all, so because what happens is that you're not going to have the luxury to govern what people are going to say.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely. So you kind of need that first, be that good impression or anything, probably starting freshman year.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I advise a lot of students, and part of when students come to ask me about getting a letter, I go look at their transcripts and I think about what did they do in class, and I'm really serious. If somebody's going to ask, if I'm going to put my name on a letter, first off, it's going to be truthful, and I'll tell you right out if I can't give you a good reference. So it's important to make sure that you're asking somebody that can really do something for you, somebody that really knows who you are somewhat. Yeah.
And it's good that he's going to be honest enough and say, I don't know you well enough, and I've done that. I don't know you well enough, or you know, I think it would be best that you find someone else. That's good that you would have someone to do that. Mm-hmm. Sometimes people will write based on what they may know or not know, and you know, it didn't always turn out in their favor.
Yes, obviously you want someone that you've kept a, you know, talking relationship with.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. Can you, for those that are trying graduate school and everything, because I've been told that it is easy. Can you discuss what are differences between an undergraduate and a graduate, the studies of that? What are the differences?
Sure. In an undergraduate, one of the first differences is we have the core for undergraduate. Mm-hmm. So you take fine arts and math and mm-hmm. science. You get to grad school, you're going to be studying one subject. Whatever it is that you know, if it's going to be history or economics or math, whatever it is, that's all you're going to do. Mm-hmm. All the other stuff is gone now. We've got the background. You're a well-rounded person. Now we're going to focus. Mm-hmm. Second, the workload's going to go up. Mm-hmm. Basically, you're going to get graduate school. Usually, you take three classes is considered a full load, most graduate schools, and you'll be glad it's only three. The expectations go up a lot. It's about the same differences between graduating from high school and coming here. It's that much again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, up that. So you can't just be casual about it.
No.
You need to be serious.
Okay. Well, I'm Catherine Harper with NSU Demon Life here with Dr. Bill Housel and Tracy LeBaum Norris. We'll be right back after the break.
Hi. I rehearse trying to convey the right emotion, so please don't cause a commotion and mess me up.
I spend countless hours moving with grace, so please be careful with flashing cameras. They can be distracting.
I spend countless hours trying to perfect my pitch, so please silence your cell phones. I want to be heard.
Please adhere to the rules so we can put on our best performance for you.
Looking for a way to stay healthy and get into shape? Then come and join NSU's Wellness Recreation and Activity Center. The rack contains two large gyms for basketball, volleyball, and badminton, racquetball courts, free weight room, strength and cardio rooms, group exercise room, and an indoor track. The rack has a fully staffed service center and will serve all of your health needs. Come and start your lifestyle change today at the NSU Rack.
KNWD is back and better than ever, with more shows and more music that you can't find anywhere else on the dial. So if you're ready for a break from the other guys, tune into 91.7 FM, The Demon. And we're always looking for energetic voices, so stop by Room 109 Kaiser and pick up an application and get ready to rock. KNWD 91.7, The Demon.
It could have been half a century ago.
Or maybe it was just last spring.
It doesn't matter how long ago you graduated, because here, you're still family.
No matter where your education has taken you, or how much you think things have changed,
Northwestern is still home.
Chronicling the times of Northwestern State University, this is Demon Life.
Hi, and welcome back to Demon Life. I'm Catherine Harper, here today with Dr. Bill Housel, Coordinator of Social Sciences, and Tracy LeBaum Norris, Assistant Director of Counseling and Career Services. Thank you once again for joining us today. Now, Dr. Housel, we were discussing the first half about graduate school and the challenges. It's more challenging, obviously, than undergraduates. Now, what do you say for those who use finance, the reason they can't go?
First thing off, do your homework. Go and check schools out, ask them what they have available. You cannot be shy about it. You have to be aggressive and you have to go after it. Also, second thing is be sensible, but don't be afraid of taking out loans. Mm-hmm. People get, and I know I talk to a lot of students, they're like, oh, a loan, I don't want to have debt. Mm-hmm. It's not the worst thing in the world. And part of the objective of getting an education is to make more money. You will make more money. Eventually, maybe not right off the bat, but you will eventually make more money. So that'll come around and you'll be able to pay your your loans. Mm. But always look and be aggressive mm-hmm. looking for financial aid. Yeah.
But you also caution against just staying in school and not getting a job and just building up the loans to where...
Yeah, again, if you take loans to go to grad school and you don't have a purpose for going, you're just incurring debt that has no point. Mm-hmm. The financial advisors call student loans good debt when you're getting something for it, you know, for the debt. But just doing it so you don't have to get a job, mm-hmm. it's an expensive way to get nowhere.
Yes. Now, what do you say about those who decide to wait a few years and then go back into graduate school and everything? Do you think they should ease their way back in or just...
I usually try to caution students against doing that mm-hmm. Just because life interferes sometimes. Mm-hmm. You get out, you get a job, you get married, you have kids, and then all of a sudden it's 10 years later and you're going, gosh, I wish I'd have gone to grad school when I had the chance, and now I'm tied down, I can't do it. I went to grad school with two small children, and it's scary to walk out with no insurance for your kids and, you know, very, very reduced paycheck. It's kind of scary stuff to do.
Absolutely. So you have to be really dedicated to go back and everything. Mm-hmm. Now, Tracy, why don't you tell us exactly what they do at the Counseling Career Services?
Well, with two-part counseling and mm-hmm. career, as far as the counseling part, we actually... offer counseling services for anyone that's part of the NSU student body, even faculty and staff and their family. Mm-hmm. So that's a service that's there for them. Mm-hmm. We also, as far as for career side of the house, we have many, many different programs that we actually do. So I guess it just depends on what it is that you may need. And, you know, we'll render those services out to you, and sometimes some will overlap according to whatever it is that your goal.
Okay.
Some of the things that we will do, first of all, we host career fairs. We do one for all majors in the fall, and we have several that we do in the spring, one for all majors in the spring, and then we have one that's designated for just education majors. And we actually partner with part of the Louisiana system and other career services elsewhere for a regional career fair that we will actually host in the spring. So we have those. We have resume services as far as helping them to write resumes and to critique them as well. So it just depends on wherever you are. We have those services that can actually meet those needs.
I was just going to say, what a great idea and everything, you know, just if you've never written a resume before, you go, I don't know what to do. So it is available on campus, and we've already paid for it, haven't we? So,
let's go up there
and get our resumes checked out. And you also hold
We do mock interviews.
Mm-hmm.
And that kind of goes hand in hand. All those two different programs, they go hand in hand, where if you come up, we can critique those resumes, help you out with that, take advantage of actually a simulated interview. Mm-hmm. That's a great opportunity to kind of cheat that first impression so that you have an opportunity to come in, get critiqued, right then and there on the spot, so you'll know before you leave, you know, here's some things that we need to work on. These are some things that you did that were wonderful, and build on those skills as well.
That's wonderful. Yeah. Now, what do you guys think about internships? I know that they're offered for jobs, and are they offered for graduate school as well?
Yes, a lot of times that's how graduate students finance mm-hmm. their graduate studies, is doing internships or doing assistantships at the university. Mm-hmm. So you can do research assistantships, you can do teaching assistantships. There's lots of different things like that available. A lot of businesses, a lot of industries will also have graduate students come as interns, and you'll actually work in the field and get credit for it.
Now, will undergraduates, if they go and do an internship right now while they're still getting their bachelor's, will that help them out
further? It's quite a bit for grad school, but even more in the job market when mm-hmm. they know you've had job experience, if you've done well anyway.
Right. Yes.
That can help you a lot.
Now, what are some mistakes that you guys have seen people applying for their graduate school or for a job? What are some of the biggest mistakes you've seen them do?
I think for graduate school, it's just not preparing carefully enough.
Yeah.
You start summer of before your senior year, you should be started.
Mm-hmm.
Looking at, do you need to take a LSAT or the CMAT or one of the other mm-hmm. exams that you take to get into grad school? Make sure that you give yourself plenty of time. You don't always do well the first time. Have time enough to take it again if you need to, and still make deadlines. Probably the biggest thing that people do that ruins their chances is not meeting deadlines.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Grad school, if you don't meet the deadline, they know they don't want you.
Mm-hmm.
They don't care if you're brilliant. If you can't meet a deadline, you don't belong there. So make sure that you research carefully whatever the universities are that you're looking for. Make sure they have the kind of thing that you're interested in, that they do, you know, look at the faculty, what do they research, what are they into. So make sure that you're going to be a good fit there, and then observe the deadlines. Absolutely be ahead of time is better.
Mm-hmm. And what about
I would say being hasty about applying, not planning, doing your homework, research. That's the biggest thing that you should do to help yourself prepare for any of those jobs that are out there in the market.
Now, do you think a location is very important? Like, obviously, if you can't stand the cold, do not go apply for a job or graduate school in New England. So, or, you know, if you don't want to be around the beach, don't go to LA, you know, for your thing. Do you think that's
Yeah, I mean, that's part of when you're considering whether it's going to work or going to grad school, either one. Where you're going to work is part of the, you know, do you have a support network there? You know, is there family or friends or somebody that you know around that you can kind of use as help there? Looking at, again, what do they teach there? What kind of work do they do at a place of business? You know, if you're a history graduate and you're trying to get a job working as a chemist down here at the paper mill, might not work out so well.
Yeah. Unless you have some really great grades in your core science classes.
Yeah.
That's true. But, you know, sometimes location, if someone wants you, mm-hmm. let's say that we love the climate here in the South, that it's pretty warm here for the most part, and you're offered something, let's say Illinois, and so it's a little, you know, the weather's totally different there. Sometimes you may have to just go if someone is willing to give you an opportunity, put in maybe a year or so, or get that experience so that you can actually, if there's something you want to do later on, you can actually say, well, I've actually worked in a professional position for X amount of time. So sometimes, you know, if someone wants you and there isn't something close by that you're interested in, it may be to your best bet to take it and then build on that.
So regardless whether you choose graduates or the job, just go directly into the job market, it's still a big change, and mm-hmm. you need to be prepared for it and just take the leap. So.
And I think another part about what she was saying is you have to be flexible.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
If you go, I'm only going to work in Louisiana, well, maybe they don't have that, you know, maybe there's not an opportunity
and
here.
And that's going to limit you.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, maybe in Minnesota.
Right.
Well, it gets cold in Minnesota, but guess what? You can buy a coat.
Exactly. So I can't go there. The Vikings are there. So.
Oh, wow.
Well, anything, you know, you guys else would like to add before we close out on the...
I would take advantage of the services. I mean, career services, counseling services, they're there. They're there for the students. It's, I mean, you'd be silly not to.
Do they have classes for that the... career services offers?
Actually, we do. We have a career development where you can, let's say that especially for like the entry freshmen and kind of the lower level classifications, if you want to learn more about you so that you can figure out what major is going to be a good fit for you, something like that, we have courses for that, which will be career development. And that's kind of like an orientation 10:30, mm-hmm. kind of being oriented to yourself. And we have a capstone course that we actually teach, and that's one to help students to transition from college to the world of work. Everyone should take advantage of that.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely.
Yes, yes.
And of course, yours is required for all
yes.
social sciences
mm-hmm.
in our senior year.
But yeah, talk to your professors. That's what we're there for.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And we know about grad schools. We went to grad school. We know
mm-hmm.
about it.
Yes. Absolutely. Well, mm-hmm. let's see. Well, this has been a very interesting and intellectual conversation with Dr. Bill Housel and Tracy LeBaum Norris. For more information, you can contact Tracy LeBaum Norris at the NSU Counseling and Career Services. Yes. Thank you and have a good night.